We have a nice bedrock layer here. Right at the front end, you get some flood gold washing in here. But I pretty much guarantee this has been done 50 times over. You will find gold here. The whole idea is to find out where there's a greater concentration of gold. So since you got a bedrock zone here to target, the rivers used to run over a guy's head at one time. As you can look, we got a nice hill and a cut going back in here. Tells me the river at one time run through here, scored this bedrock. So to increase your chances, get off the river. As you can see, there's a rounded river rock poking out there. We'll go back in here, explore. And there you go. You're off the river. Better chance at some better gold. You can see we got a slide. River rocks. And if you look up top, there's the old channel that run on the other side of that bedrock zone. We'll sample up here and see if we can find any color. And by looking at the layers, you can tell that this is an old river. It's not a glacier till. It's not a landslide. It's definitely an old channel. Okay, I just packed out 5 gallon bucket sample. It's more of a uniform gravel that I took the sample from. It was fairly cemented. We'll see what kind of gold's in here. Okay, sample one turned out a trace of gold out of a 5 gallon bucket, but that don't mean nothing this stage of the game. It says first sample, and I picked the side that I thought most likely had the least amount of gold. We're going to go back up there and we're going to center basically the middle of the old channel, and we'll sample that. A little more gravel, a little larger rock, hopefully a little bigger gold. We'll soon find out. Trace of gold, a little more than sample one, not as much as I would expect in this area. So I'll sample a different spot, determine if this bench in the hill is worthwhile chasing or not. So you guys should sample multiple levels. It could be a pay zone underneath the slide area down into bedrock. But I'm going to keep on the same plane here, and I'm going to sample over with these larger boulders in the deeper part of the U and see what types of gold come out of this spot. You can see there's a gravel layer resting on a almost a sandstone, very compact sand with a boulder garden on top. It's almost like a couple different events maybe happened in this area. We'll sample underneath these large boulders at the bottom here and see what we pull out. Still a trace of gold, nothing special, you know, maybe enough to pay for the diesel if you were to machine operate in that area. But it does tell us lots. There was very little quartz, lots of black and red rock. There was lots of fractured bedrock,
and worn granules of basically the schist stone bedrock. All clues for later on in your sampling when you run across an area like this in the bush, you know. You should already have a good idea of what to expect out of them gravel layers. A slope here, large boulder poking out, another one there. We found the river gravels. We're starting to find the fractured bedrock, which is a good sign because I'd like to hit the bedrock underneath here. For now, I'm going to take a 5-gallon bucket sample from underneath this big rock and we'll see if we get any color. Found lots of heavies, lots of black sand, trace of gold. There's about, counted so far, probably about 11 fairly small pieces, not quite flower gold, but that's just the top layer so far. But one thing I'm noticing with all the samples I've been taking in this area is the amount of black heavies, the lack of quartz rocks. The gold seems to be a little finer, but like I said, I'm still not on a false bedrock layer or a bedrock layer. Hey, I pulled a pretty good sample off this false bedrock layer of clay. It's pretty interesting looking. Colors, seems like a few different layers, so I scraped about 6 inches of the top of the clay as well. We'll pan this sample out and we'll see what we get. Turned up some not bad gold. Bedrock layers, false bedrock layers, generally will have better averages anyway. It's nothing to get too excited about. There's a fair amount of material. But yeah, to further sample that, the guy would have to open that up quite a bit. Dig down to a bedrock layer and sample that. See, I got two different piles here. When you're doing sampling, especially on different layers, keep track of your rocks and all your quartzes. I got a good size old channel leading in another direction on the side of this riverbank, but it's collapsed on itself. The high waters washed quite a bit of it across this area here. There's a little bit of a clay layer. Well, this is the last pan. Cleaned this little pocket out here pretty good. Off this collapsed old bench. Let's see if any good gold is dropped in here. Well, a little pocket. Turned up a couple little pickers.